Hi, I'm Nick from Australian Native Bee, and today I want to take you through a question that I'm getting asked more and more with people's seductions, micro colonies, and propagation in general. And that is, how do I tell whether I have a queen or not? And there's a few little indicators and a few signs that you can look for. And as you do it more and more, you'll get better at it and be able to quickly look in a hive and tell whether you have a queen. So I'll just take you through that and show you what I do. All right, behind me here, I have this season's hives, which I'm starting off. And I'll just take you through those and show you inside each one of them and how to tell whether I have a queen and whether that hive is going to go ahead. Alrighty, number one, let's have a look in here. Okay. What I can see in here is some honey pots being built up here. I can see that there's an involucrum going and honey pots down there. Because they've covered the brood up quickly, there's a queen in this hive. Number two, let's have a look in here. Alright, brood isn't covered in this hive, and also there's this. When stingless bees don't have a queen, they will begin to build this odd structure straight up. It's very stringy. Becomes like noodles, and you'll notice it will come straight up. So those guys do not have a queen yet. Alright, I can tell already without even opening this plastic that these guys, let's focus that, there's heaps of bees in here. There's a queen being right next to that other hive. I would say that some of these bees have drifted into this box because of the smell of a queen, so a confirmed queen in that hive. Right, let's look in this hive. These guys have a queen, a little bit slow to start. They have a queen. But Nick, they've got stringy stuff, yes, but they've covered the involucrum here. They're starting a honey pot there. And there's good numbers of bees in that hive. Right, let's get this one open. Let's have a look in here. Oh, okay, this is an interesting one here. Now, this hive does not have a queen, and they know they do not have a queen. And you can see their behaviour is very slow. The bees are walking slow, they're not all over the place. You saw the other hive I opened, they came straight out. They're defending. Now down here, that, there's several of them down there. There's one, are emergency queen cells that the bees are making. And basically what they've done, I think they're working on some here, is they've opened some of the brood that I've placed in here. They've extended the walls out and they're going to bring them up till that becomes a queen cell. So no, they do not have a queen, but yes, they're working on one. Let's put this back here. Right, let's have a look in this one. I think everybody can guess. Haven't got stringy structure, we've got covering and lots of bees. There is a queen in that one. Queen in that one. You guys get the idea. You can very quickly tell whether you've got a queen in a hive or not. Even before opening this, I can tell. Because not only are the bees all clustered, you can see that they're moving a little bit quicker, there's a little bit more excited behaviour there than the other one. And down here they've built a massive entrance on the vent hole at the back. So that's a good sign. Lucky lass, let's have a look in here. You can see it. Yes, that's got a queen. Even though they haven't got honey pots, the covering of the wax is a good indicator you've got a queen. And also the way the wax is built. If it's solid, big structures, then that's a good sign of a queen. You'll know when you see in your own hives whether you haven't got a queen. The structure changes. Also, over time, the colour of the wax changes. This is a really rich colour brown. And the wax will slowly turn darker over time if you're not going to get a queen out of it. So there you go. I hope this little video helps people to understand when they have a queen or not. Change.